Psalm 22, verse 3. It says, "You are enthroned as the Holy One, the one whom Israel praises. You are the source of our strength, and you the strength of our lives." Please join me in singing Throne of Praises to the Lord of Lords and King of Kings.
Jesus, we lift you on our praises, so every eye can see your face, your power and grace. Behold you as you really are, brighter than all the stars of heaven. Our worship is for you alone. We build you this throne. As I have breath, I'll find a way to say that I love you. Everything may change, the world may pass away, I still love you. With every song we sing, sound of praise. Jesus, we lift you on our praises, so every eye can see your face, your power and grace. Behold you as you stars of heaven. Our worship is for you alone. We build you this throne of Jesus. We lift you on our praises, so every eye can see your face, your power. Stars of heaven, our worship is for you alone. We build you this throne of praise. We build you this throne of praise. We build you this throne of praise.
Mighty brothers and sisters, we've reflected on the different gifts of the Holy Spirit. And today we come to the third section of the Corinthian gifts, or the ministerial gifts. And these are called gifts of power, not of our power, but of the power of God working in and through us. And this section again consists of three gifts: the gift of faith, the gift of healing, and the gift of miracles. Let's look at each of these. First is the gift of faith. Very often you'd say, "Father, I have faith. I profess the faith every Sunday at Mass in the Apostles' Creed." Yes, that is not the faith we are referring to when we speak of this gift. That is a faith that you are baptized into. That is the faith that you profess, that you believe. But the gift of faith is for a specific time, for a specific moment, in a specific situation. It is the ability to know that God will work in this situation. And so, for example, When Jesus multiplies the loaves and the fish, he knows that God is going to work. He has that faith. The Gospel of John tells us very clearly, he asked Andrew as a test. He himself knew what he was going to do. So Jesus knew very clearly, and he had that faith to know. We see that when Paul is, these days when we're reading the Acts of the Apostles, we know that when Paul is preaching, he sees someone who is lame. And when Paul's eyes and that beggar's eyes meet, he recognizes that this man has the gift of faith, and that man is healed. And so the gift of faith is really a sense or an ability that God gives us in a particular situation at a particular moment, where you know without an iota of doubt that God will make this happen. Sometimes it is the impossible, and God will make this happen. It's a deep conviction within our heart, within our spirit, within our mind, that God will make these things happen. That is the gift of faith that we are speaking of. Not the faith that we profess, that all of us have. But the gift of faith is there for that moment, and then it's not there. Again, in another situation, it would perhaps operate again. And so, for example, when you're praying over people, when you're reaching out to people, sometimes there is this conviction that this person will go back healed. We see this very often in prayer meetings, and you would have noticed this phenomenon. Sometimes the preacher would say, this person is healed, or that person is healed, or so many people are healed. How does the person know it? Because the gift of faith is operating at that moment in that particular leader. This is the gift of faith. Second is the gift of healing. The gift of healing can be seen in four situations. The first is touch. The second is the word. The third is through time. And fourth is by using matter. Through touch, we see in the Gospels that Jesus touches someone and the person is healed instantaneously. Touch. This is an instant way of healing. Sometimes there is no explanation. A person has gone to the doctors. We have that woman with hemorrhages. She's gone to doctors for 13 years and nothing has happened. But she has the gift of faith operating. If I only touch the fringe of his garment, I will be healed. And the moment she touches, she is healed. That's the gift of healing operating. The gift is operating on the behalf of Jesus, but also on behalf of that woman. The second is the gift of the word, where Jesus, with a word, will either cast out a demon or will heal someone. We see this very often, the synagogue official's daughter, servant, when Jesus says, he will be healed, go back on your way. Or the centurion servant, where Jesus, he says, I'm not worthy to have you under my roof, but say the word and my servant will be healed. Just say the word. So healing operates through touch. It operates through word. It operates also through time. And so, for example, we have Jesus healing the blind man gradually. It's not an instantaneous healing. The healing happens over a period of time. And this is what we see. Again, the lepers, when Jesus cleanses the 10 lepers, he sends them on their way. And as they are going, one of them recognizes that he has been healed. It's a gradual process. And so we see healing happen in this gradual way. And finally, through matter. We see this, for example, in the parable of the Good Samaritan, who picks up the wounded man and he pours oil and wine in his wounds. Okay, again, we have in the letter of St. James, are any among you sick? Let them call for the priests of the church and they will anoint them with oil and say the prayer of healing, and that person will be healed. And this is what we see in the sacraments of healing. So in the sacraments, we use matter, and this is crucial for healing. The gift of healing operates for the sake of glorifying God. The primary purpose, as we've already seen, is to build up the kingdom of God. When I am healed, I am more disposed to pray to God. I am more disposed to recognize the power of God. And therefore, these are called gifts of power. The third is the gift of miracles. Now, healings are also miracles, but miracles is a more general term. And what do we mean when we say the gift of miracles? It is God's power at work that works in conjunction with the preaching of the word. And we see this, for example, in the Acts of the Apostles. At Pentecost, the apostles receive the Holy Spirit, and Peter goes out and preaches, and 3,000 are converted. But later on, we know that when Peter and John heal the crippled, 5,000 are converted. What is the difference? In both, they are preaching the word of God. In the second example, we have also a miracle that takes place. We see this also when Jesus feeds the 5,000. When all of them have had their fill, the people want to take him by force and make him king. And Jesus has to escape because they haven't understood everything. So sometimes in miracles, things cannot always be understood as they ought to be understood. But miracles generally support the preaching of the word of God. When we preach, the miracles only assist and they reinforce the preaching. And therefore we have these three gifts of power where the power of God is manifested: faith, healing, and miracles. And again, how do we receive this? How do we receive these gifts? Very clearly, two ways. One, obviously, by asking. Ask in prayer. Lord, I am in this situation. I am dealing with this person. This person needs to feel your healing touch. This person needs to see a miracle. And so work a miracle for your glory. God will work. Second, you have to preach the word of God, because these gifts support the word of God being preached. And so the gift of faith, the gift of healing, and the gift of miracles are gifts of power that support the preaching of the word of God. Wherever you go out and evangelize and you preach, people will be healed, because these gifts will also operate in conjunction. And so I want to invite you, my dear brothers and sisters, as you participate in this novena, to ask for these gifts. The Holy Spirit will give you these gifts. Don't worry about it, but ask for the right intention to build up the kingdom of God, to glorify God's name, to build up the church, to reach out in service, and God will give you these gifts. Have a wonderful day. May God bless you, and may you bring the Spirit to everyone you meet today and every day. God bless you.